Hey guys, what's good? This is Andre, and today I want to go over position sizing, risk management, and how to average in on a winning position and kind of let your winners run, as the saying goes. I honestly have struggled with this for the longest time, and I've found success by following these kind of simple principles that I'm about to outline here. I do encourage everybody to kind of think about them. Offer me your own thoughts in the comment section below. Before we jump in here, guys, if you want to see my trade setups and kind of how I'm going about things, how I'm finding 2 or 3 to 1 risk reward ratio trades, and some of those ideas, as well as support the channel, head on over to Patreon, and for $5 a month you can support the channel and help me continue the work that I'm doing here. Now, moving back on the topic here, guys, so I've outlined Dollar General the other week. I think it was roughly Wednesday or Thursday when I was actually showing you guys this stock exactly at this peak over here. As you can see, you can go back and watch that video. This risk reward setup here, this short, remained in place ever since that moment. So basically what I was saying then is what I'm gonna reiterate now, which is that we should have taken a short position here for Dollar General against this trend line from $220. Now, a few days have gone by, the stock has gone to $216, and you could have already pocketed that profit, which is something that you should do in some instances. And you know, it's a bigger discussion here. Are you a day trader? Are you a swing trader? Are you a longer term kind of, not investor, but trader that takes trades that last weeks to sometimes months? I think it's really important for you to determine what type of trader you are before you execute trades, or just try out a few things and see what works best with your style. I'm gonna probably do a video about that pretty shortly here, but today that's not the main topic. So in this case here, what I want to go over with you guys is, let's say you have taken a risk here, and I encourage all of you guys to not risk more than 2% of your overall stake when taking a trade. And I know 2% can sound difficult, so let's just take a scenario here. Let's say you have $1,000 to trade and you want to risk 2% of $1,000. I'm not going for bigger portfolios because I know that not a lot of you guys here have kind of $50,000 portfolio that you can trade with. So at $1,000, your max risk on this trade needs to be $20. That $20 is basically going to be your max loss for the trade. So in this case, with an entry point at roughly $200 or $220, and the initial stop that we had set out here just above this Fibonacci level at 224.5, that means $4.50 of risk for every single one share that you buy. And so that means that for $20 of overall loss that you have for this one trade, you should have bought not more than 4 shares for this one position. 4 shares means $800 from your overall $1,000 portfolio. And I understand that that sounds a lot, but losing $20 does not, right? So in the scenario where this trade goes in your favor and you manage to pocket $20 on those 4 shares that you've bought, you've made $80 for a max risk of $20. Again, investing $800 of your initial $1,000 portfolio might sound risky, but when you have a clear stop loss at $20, that's 2% of your overall portfolio, so it's absolutely fine. You shouldn't go above 2%, and oftentimes if your portfolio is big enough, you probably shouldn't go above 1% in the first place. Now, let's kind of scratch that scenario and say that you have a bigger portfolio, you can afford buying or selling more shares here. So you have entered this initial position and the trade is going in your direction. You're a swing trader that enjoys staying in trades for days to weeks, and you still see that we are very much respecting the downtrend here. We are still very much going with the trend, trading with the trend. So now we have the opportunity to move our stop a lot lower, because if the stock price, it already confirmed that there was a valid resistance here, there's no point in not moving the stop loss, right? We're going to move our stop loss just above the previous peak of these two candles over here, because that would represent a break of market structure if we break not only the trend line but also those two peaks. And now you can think about whether or not you want to add another position, since your risk just went from $4 a share to one and change a share, and you can recalculate what that means, right? So moving back to the kind of $1,000 scenario, you went from being able for the $20 overall max loss that you could have taken to short a maximum amount of 4 shares, you go to being able to short 3 times that amount of shares, because you now only have $1.50 to risk for every single 1 share that this trade goes against you. Now, that's a hypothesis here. The second one would be to take your loss to break even, and it's actually what I would do, because if we manage to break above this trend line, for me, that's indication enough of the fact that the trend is becoming more bullish, or is beginning to trade, to change, sorry. As you guys can see, we have already made previous highs, so if this channel doesn't kind of, because every single trade is formed of big waves, so kind of the major trend and then minor retracements within the major trend, and we can see that we have a big downward trend here, and for now the minor trend has actually reversed to the upside by making a higher high here, but the major trend is still very much to the downside. So that's what I would do, guys. I would move the break even here, or I would move the stop here to break even, and I would consider adding another stop position as soon as the dollar amount or the price action here reaches back against the trend line, or maybe even as soon as it hits the 18-day moving average. But that's just a strategy that I sometimes use. You should definitely try to find a strategy that works with your style. But as I was saying, we can now enter a new short position, and what I would do personally with this short position, as I was telling you, is just place the stop right above the previous peaks of those two candles, and I would probably aim, actually I added a long position here, so give me a sec please. I would probably aim for the take profit, so I've got a very tight stop loss here of roughly $3, and so that allows me to take a very quick 2-to-1. I'm going to potentially make $8, that's even more than 2-to-1. I'm gonna make $8 for the 3, so I probably will just go on and attempt to make the $6 that would give me a 2-to-1 risk reward ratio. I would take profit on the second trade first, and I would let my first trade, that is now moved to break even, that's a free trade, I can be patient with it, I would let that retest this bottom area and give me the full profit of that initial trade. That's how I would play these, guys. If you have any questions, I know this might be a bit complicated. I'm gonna try to offer you guys a couple more of these examples with other trades coming up in the next couple of weeks as they set up and we have the opportunity to talk through them. But this is the way I would play this. If you want your stocks broken down, leave it in the comment section below. I'm more than happy to cover that. Support the channel on Patreon. Thanks so much for all the Patreons that already support us, and have a fantastic weekend, guys. Take care. See you next week.